Very good afternoon to one and all. So today the topic which I am going to cover is genetic algorithm. So like in the morning session you had learned about little about optimization. So this genetic algorithm is also an optimization technique. It is a bio-inspired optimization technique. Like if you see in the nature, God has created us in such a way that like he has given many features you can see. In day-to-day life or the climate change, anything if you see, there are some basics behind it, some mathematics or some something going behind it. And these things cannot be written in the form of an equation or something. They are in the form of some algorithms, okay? Some permutations or some probability function, that those ways you can put it. So here, this genetic algorithm, it's a bio-inspired, taking into the reproduction of the human. Based on that, this algorithm is developed, and this is used to find a maxima or a minima. Any problem if you take, there will be sometimes you want to maximize something. So what are the things you like to maximize? Some example, which one you want to maximize in your field? Profit. If you have a company, you want to maximize the profit. Being an electrical engineer, I'll say I want to increase my efficiency, maximize my efficiency. Accuracy, correctness, or maximum power I want. So some features are there which you have to minimize. Cost, many a times. Cost, error, energy consumption. So according to your field, you know, you want to maximize something or you want to minimize something. Generally I'm saying, say some equation is there, you maximize it. Which method will you use? General, before these algorithms were these algorithms came into picture, which one will you use? Mathematic, that is calculus technique. Okay, so before, so you just we'll go to the slide. So genetic algorithm. So first, to maximize or minimize, we use calculus techniques, mathematical techniques. In this, you have a function f of x, and this function you either differentiate, you first differentiate it, okay, you first differentiate this function, and you will see that whether this differentiation of this function is, say with respect to time or something, you have differentiated, and you'll see whether it is zero or not. If it is zero, what do you, what conclusion can you get it? Is it maximum? It may be maximum, it may be minimum, or it may be an inflection. That is what you find. For just let us take an example. I'm just taking an example of a projectile. I'm taking a stone and I'm just throwing it up. Okay, it takes a projectile shape. I have written the motion equation of that, which you can see here. So this is the motion equation. Okay, so now first I will differentiate it. So when I differentiate, I get dy by dt is equal to zero in all the three cases. So I have differentiated and I found that something I have achieved. It may be a maximum, it may be a minimum, or it may be an inflection. So how will I find that whether it was a maximum, whether it was a minimum, or whether it was an inflection? For that, we again differentiate it. In calculus technique, that is what we do. The second differentiation of any equation is nothing but the energy of that system. Whichever system, if we say that, it is the energy of that system. So you just think, when I second differentiated, if the energy is less than zero, what does it mean? In the sense, it is having no energy. You have second differentiated and you found that it is having no energy. Surely that system will come down. So it is in the maximum. So that gives you a conclusion that we have reached the maximum of that system or the parameter, whichever parameter, we have reached the maximum. Again, we are differentiating it. If that value is greater than zero, if it is greater than zero, what conclusion we can come? It is having some energy. It can either move up or it can again accelerate. So we come to a conclusion that it has reached its minimum. First differentiation should be zero. Then only when you do the second differentiation, it will give you whether it was a minimum or maxima or all these things. The third thing, if the energy is equal to zero, it was just an inflection. Some change had occurred, but it was neither the minimum or the maxima. So this was a very simple technique which we were using and was good. Then why do you want to go for all these techniques? Genetic algorithm optimizes, so many optimization algorithms are there. When you have such a beautiful thing, then what is the need for these algorithms? Somebody was asking, why should I go for this algorithm, this algorithm? Might be these are the things. It is not that all the cases. You just take a case like you have a system with one single heap. For this, it will give you an accurate answer. Will it? It is only a single heap. Okay. Here, calculus technique, what we do, we draw the slope. You draw if it is a positive slope or negative slope or zero slope, you find. Okay, so you can easily find it. In this case, if you apply calculus, you will sharply go to that point. So for such a problem, where there is only a single heap or single thing, you need not go for these optimization algorithms. Unnecessary, it is complication. Many times our students also, they have an equation which can be easily solved with calculus. But in order to show that we have done GA, because GA can also solve this, it will give you a better answer. But to show that I have done GA, I have done PSO, our students also, they apply. So if we ask them, why did you apply? Ma'am, nowadays the latest trend, the latest algorithm is this. Okay, so first of all, we have to identify a problem. In that problem, what type of atmosphere or what type of environment is there, whether it is required or not. That is a very important thing. Say there are two heaps. Can I go for algorithm or this one? These calculus techniques. Here also you can go for calculus. It's not a very big deal. Only two heaps are there. Go and find the both the heaps, the slope. Automatically, this can also give you the answer. With calculus itself, you can do it. You need not go for all these difficult algorithms. Okay. But I have a system like this. Now, I am really confused. If I write the algorithm also, so many heaps are there. They are of same size. Some are high. So you just think, I have a person, I have blindfolded him and I'm sending the room and I'm telling go and find. Previous case, he would have slightly, he climbed, he would have gone to the top and he would have found, okay, I have reached the top. But in this case, he will really get confused, is it? So that is the main thing. We have to find where is our peak. So for a simple example, I'm taking an electrical example only to just show you a problem. Where is a single heap? Which algorithm I lose, or why did I go for GA in that particular problem? So that I'm going to tell you. So for that is the best example of maximum power tracking of a solar panel. I think all of you know a solar panel. So if you want that solar panel should give me the maximum power, what should I do? It should be directly facing the sun. Okay, so what I can do is one method is automatic sun tracking. This is the technique where as the sun's position changes, I am just rotating my solar panel. Okay, so this as first it faces the east, then I just take the irradiation with some sensors when it is moving automatically. So this, but the problem in this technique is here each, you should have a motor which should rotate this. Already it is generating power and that power is also wasted. So people, we don't go for this technique. We go for electrical techniques. Searching for the MPPT. We are searching the MPPT point. In that case, depending on the latitude and longitude of your place, say Chandigarh, it is some angle, 25 degrees. You fix the solar panel in that. You will not move it. After that, we use a technique where MPPT technique in order to track the maximum point. So a general characteristics of a solar panel is what you see it in the slide. So this is the general characteristics of the solar panel. So here you can see that this is the maximum point which I have to track. Can I do this? Which technique will I use? Some linear calculus technique. Okay. So in this case, what I can do, I will just find, you have different techniques, that is perturb and observe. I will observe the system, then I will disturb the system, and again I'll observe the system. So first when I observe, let me just take my first point was V1 and I1, my current and voltage was this. Then again I disturb my system by some means And again, I absorbed this point. So it was V2, I2. So what I can infer from this? I have not reached my maximum point. If I again disturb, it can go and reach my maximum point. If this, after crossing, if I perturb my system, if I'm getting this, in this case, the voltage is increasing, but the current is decreasing. I come to a conclusion that I have crossed my MPPT point. So this is a calculus technique, or there are number of conventional techniques. Say one more technique is there where I draw the slope. That is said to be the incremental conductance method. I draw a slope, and if it is a positive slope, I am on my left side of the MPPT. If the slope is a negative slope like this, I can say I'm on my right of my MPPT. If it is zero slope, I come to a conclusion that I am on the MPPT. So all these things are here also what you do. You want to find the slope, you differentiate it. These are all general calculus technique. Very beautiful technique. I can find my maximum point. Okay, so there is no problem. I don't want to go for any other algorithm. Then what does it need in case I want to apply GA? In which condition can I apply? There is a solar panel. Okay. According to this electrical technique, I'll tell you, say you have a solar panel. Because many of you, I told it generally, you will not understand it. Once again, let me tell. This is your solar panel. So generally when you connect, what you do is you connect a DC to DC converter here. Okay, this may be like it is DC to DC itself, like just like a transformer. Here it is a DC to DC converter, and you connect it to a load. So your load is here in this position, your load is there. So what is maximum power is, you would have learned in your first year, maximum power transfer theorem. Whenever the source impedance, okay, and the load impedance matches, when the source impedance and load impedance matches, maximum power will transfer from this to this. In the sense, at that point, it will be operating at this point. So in order to find this, one method is we just see what is the voltage here. We see what is the current here. And that is by, this is the point. Disturbing this point, in the sense you are giving a firing pulse to this and you are disturbing this. So automatically, again, the voltage and current will change. You are seeing that whether the voltage and current is increasing or decreasing. And that is how you find it using the calculus technique. Okay. It's a very simple technique. Now, let me just imagine a case like this. You can see it on the PPT. Say here, this is said to be partial shading. Say in all your institutes, you would have seen on the roofs, they would have put solar panels. So something called partial shading occurs. What is partial shading? Yeah, it is in the sense, say some dust is there. Nobody is going to clean it every day. So some dust has accumulated. So that time radiation will not fall on it. Or due to the sun's position, some shadow will fall on it. Some tree's shadow may fall, or some bird or something is sitting, which is creating a partial shading. So what will happen is, this is a solar panel, like strings. Usually they are in the form of strings. So you can see here, the first string, there is no partial shading, whole current is flowing. In the second string, only one portion, one of the solar panel is shaded. In the third case, two of the solar panels are shaded. Okay, so in this case, what happens, when you find the overall, like the overall characteristics, you can see here, the first one, this is the blue, which you can see here. The second one is this green. And the third solar panel, strings panel is this red. So the equivalent of this is this. So here, can you see multiple peaks? So here, this is a local peak. This is a local peak. And this is a global peak. So in this case, which algorithm can I go? Huh? Hill climbing, that is calculus. Hill climbing is the perturb and observe, which I told is nothing but the hill climbing. There also calculus can work. Only three strings are there. Only three peaks I'm going to get. And that global, it is one peak is there. You can go for it. But just imagine, say, this is three peaks. You have a group of solution. This solution will go and choose which is your peak in this case. But just take a situation like this. The irradiation, when you measure in the solar panel, it is not constant. You go and stand in the sun and you just measure that irradiation. It will be 900, then within seconds it will become 800, then 700. So you will not be prayer. That peaks are also not constant. That is going on changing. Okay. That is going on changing. In such cases, it is very difficult to go and find the peak. So when dynamic systems are there, even for simple things you can do. I don't say genetic algorithm you can't use for linear or like any non-linear equation also. You can go for calculus techniques. Calculus techniques can also is also better. But when you have problems which are complicated to solve, then you choose such algorithms. Here you can apply even GA, you can apply even PSO, you can apply any technique. Again, you have to come and see for this problem, if it is an offline problem and I know a fixed thing, okay, this is what is going to happen, then I can go for GA. But GA, the calculation time will be little more. It will give you the exact answer, but the calculation time is more. But same thing if you do PSO. PSO, the time of solving the problem is little faster compared to GA. Okay, so if I want to implement this so same system in a smart grid, where the grid is connected to this solar panel, it is a dynamic system and any change may occur anytime, and I have to do the calculation online every time. In such case, I think better than GA, let me go to PSO, because PSO is faster. Okay, so each algorithm has some feature. So when you study the algorithm, you will understand ki what are the important features of every algorithm. First, you have to note down, my GA is very fast, slow, but it will give me accurate result. So you just have an application where slow also chalega, no problem. It is not that like if it is little slow, nothing is going to happen. There you can go for such algorithm. But speed, and same way when you choose any controller also, microcontroller, any dedicated application, you go for microcontroller. But I want some application which should be very fast, you go for FPGA. So same way here also, algorithm, there are different factors by which you choose the algorithm. First of all, you have to know the algorithm. What are the different positive features of this? Just make a table with different algorithms, their positive features and negative features. And for your problem, you just see which algorithm is better. That is how you just choose which algorithm do you want to choose. Okay, so just I gave you a simple thing. So now let us go to this genetic algorithm. So this is the MPPT problem. So any electrical or electronics people are there, it will be interesting. So same thing we implemented in our lab also, this problem. So here you can see, this is what I said. This is voltage I am measuring using a sensor. I am giving it to a controller. Similarly, the current with a current sensor, we have measured and we have given to a controller. So the controller here used is DSpace, okay, CLP1104, it is a DSP processor. Okay, you can have microcontrollers, you can have DSP, or you can have FPGA, depending on the speed of the application, like how fast you want to calculate, depending on that, and cost also. Microcontroller is very cheap, DSP is little costly, FPGA is very costly. So I don't want very costly, little slow also problem, then similarly, that is how you choose this controller. Accuracy, based on that, how much accurate result, FPGA will give you very accurate result. So if you want very accurate, you go for it. So same way you choose this, and this is the algorithm portion. In the computer, using MATLAB or any software, based on the controller what you use, you will have some software here. Okay, FPGA, then you will have Xilinx or Cortex or some VHDL programming you will be doing. With MATLAB also VHDL you can program. So that is the program which is present here. So this voltage, what you have taken here, through this controller, it goes to your program here. You will acquire that analog to digital, you will acquire it. Similarly, this current, it is going to this portion. Okay, and your algorithm, it may be a GA, it may be PSO, it may be neural network, it may be fuzzy. Depending on the application, you can choose which algorithm. You just want a black box, you are giving, you know, like this is what is going to happen. Then you train a neural network and keep. If this is my voltage, this is my current, this should be my duty cycle. There is no much change or something. You can even train a neural network. We are done with neural network. We have done it with ANFIS. We have done with this optimization. But I said, when there is a partial shading, even a neural network sometimes will not be able to predict, because it will not have, if you are not trained with such a data, because I don't know what type of data will come in real time. Okay, an aeroplane passing suddenly. Okay, so this, if I have a good data, then okay. But I don't know what type of condition, which day, what, for particular moisture, it is a rainy day. So how this condition will be there? So in that case, neural network will also fail. Then you can go for optimization techniques, which will optimize and give you. So your algorithm is here. This is your algorithm, which you can see. It may be a GAPS or any algorithm. You can put it here. And this is giving you a firing pulse as output. This is the duty cycle. This from the algorithm, again, you take it through the hardware here and fire this DC to DC converter. And this DC to DC converter, what is doing when you fire? It is doing impedance matching and it will transfer the maximum power. This is real-time implementation, how we do it. Okay, so now we are going to the search techniques. So sir would have also told some linear or calculus techniques, already basics you have learned. So search techniques, generally, if you see, you have the calculus-based techniques, you have guided random search technique or enumerative techniques. So here, this guided search, evolutionary algorithms are there. In that, it comes the genetic algorithm. So genetic algorithm also many sequential algorithms you can write that. It depends on how you program it. It can be sequential or it may be parallel also. Okay. So now we are just going to genetic algorithm. So this genetic algorithm, it's commonly used prominent computational algorithm, which was introduced by I. Richenberg in 1960. Okay, this was in 1960 introduced. It was introduced, and John Holland in 1975, again, he modified it and he took it into practical applications. So this, as you all know, it is an evolutionary algorithm which mimics Darwin's theory of evolution by natural selection. The survival of the fittest, you would have heard. Okay, so that is Darwin's theory. The one who survives will go forward, others will die out. So that is the basics of this genetic algorithm. So as first of all, coming to the structure of our cell, because we are mimicking this one. So our cell, a body cell, if you see, it has a nucleus in the center. And that nucleus has something called chromosome inside. So these are the chromosomes, and there are 23 pairs, that is 46 chromosomes in each of this nucleus. Okay, so here these 46 chromosomes or 23 pairs, what you say, these chromosomes have this structure, the DNA. These are made up of these genes, you can say. So the genes have these DNAs, and these DNAs, they link in between them are the proteins. And these proteins they are said to be the allele. In the sense, each protein will give you some, here in our problem, it will be the bits, which will carry some information. Okay, so here these alleles, it gives different features, very important features like the eye color of our body, the hair color, the hair texture, okay, the body structure, everything, the skin color, everything is being given by these strings. So when we program it, we take all these strings, like it in the form of numbers. Okay, so that we will see step by step. So these are the very important features which will construct a human, you can say, or which a human being will have all these features, and these features go on. A very simple algorithm. First, what we do is we initialize a population. Okay, we initialize a population, then we evaluate them. Okay. And then we put them, like that whole population, you just take it into, for example, let me just give you an example. Here there is a classroom of around, say around 15 people are there. So my problem is, I want somebody, because I forgot something, and I want somebody to go and take some chalk or something from my room and come here. So I have to first choose which is my population. So how can I identify that who will be better, that they can go fast and come back? I can't simply say, sir, you come here, I can't do it. So what I do is, I'll just ask, how many are there who are good in outdoor sports? So some three people will say, we are good. In that, I'll again ask, who is good in athletics? Okay, so like, I can just group. So I have a very big population. In that, I can group it. Say, if three people are there in athletics, three are there. Then what I do, I evaluate them. I'll give a small distance or something. I'll tell, run there, go take it and come. So I can just, when I evaluate, I'll find ki, okay, in this three, who is best? In that best, I will take one. Okay, so similarly here, first of all, in our program, First, I will initialize the population. I have a very small, maybe thousands are there in that, around like 30 people I take, and then I evaluate them. After evaluating them, I just take them and do a process called first selection. In this three best which I've choose, who is the best? Okay, so what I do, each one I've evaluated. So in this problem, what is my thing? Speed is the thing. So I will be writing the equation for speed, and I will calculate at what speed has he done it. So distance also, say distance x1, y1, and x2, y2, two points are there. Based on that distance, I calculated what speed he has gone. So that speed function is my objective function here. For each, all the three I've evaluated now. Now, I have to find in this three, who is the best. So I want, say around five are there. In this five, I want to choose only three people to go into the next generation. So these three, how will I do? I've evaluated each one. So that evaluated value divided by sum of all the three. That will give me the probabilistic function. That, okay, so from this probabilistic function, I can find who are the best. So from that also, say 50% I'm choosing. Around five are there, I choose some two or three, and others I will eliminate it. That is selection process. From a population, after evaluating them, I am just selecting somebody. After that, I make them crossover. Okay, so they will be in the form of pairs. Joe, I'm selecting five, there are 10 people, that is, they are in the form of pair. So here, every time the population what you choose should be even. Okay, then only you can do this crossover, mutation, and all those things. So first we cross them, we get a solution. Sometimes we do mutation. I'll tell you why we are doing all these things. Then the solution what we are getting, again we will evaluate. And we see that whether they are reducing their time, whether they are going faster. In this three also, who is going faster? The child is again going fast, then it is better. Otherwise, if it is not good, I will eliminate it. So this is the overall process. Okay, this is the overall process which is going to happen. So let me just go to the problem here. So first, I am initializing a population. I think you understood what is initializing a population. Evaluating the population. Okay, and then I just check the termination criteria. Termination criteria may be anything. I'm giving there are 1,000 iterations. There are 1,000 generation. That is iteration here. If that is reached, terminate. Or if I've got the best solution, I had to get zero. My harmonic should be zero. I've achieved that zero, then stop it. I need not go till 1,000. Okay. So in or otherwise, around 10, 15 times, I'm getting the same wrong answer. Okay, I should get zero, but I'm getting 50, around 10, 15 times. Then I come to a conclusion that might be it will not terminate. Let me leave it. So that you can give any termination criteria in your problem. So you have terminated, then you go, whether the termination condition is not, that is while I'm given. Continuously it will go on. If the termination condition is not satisfied, it will go and select the parents. Then it will do a crossover and mutation. Again, it evaluates. And then again, it comes here one more terminate, like after evaluating, you have to eliminate the unwanted thing. That point should also be given. So this is how the algorithm works. Am I fast? So next, again, I'm just graphically, I'm saying, say here the parent, it'll go here. There is a population. You select some parents, you make them do reproduction, and the child, again, you're modifying, you're doing crossover and mutation. Again, you're evaluating. If the child is the better solution, you again put them in the cycle. Otherwise, you discard them. You remove them. So first, we were telling about population. So what is this population? How will you choose the population? So here, the population in our case, always remember, for our problem, the population will be the solution. Okay, your solution is the problem. You just go and put that solution in your fitness function. You solve it. Then only you can solve, na? Say you have a equation, if it is electrical, I can tell it with some example. I'll take an electrical example itself until suddenly some other example is not coming to my mind. Say, for example, a THD equation is there. Total harmonic distortion reduction. Okay, I want to reduce the total harmonic reduction. So that is given by a voltage equation, which is nothing but square root of all the harmonics. It may be a fifth harmonic square plus seventh harmonic square. Different harmonics divided by the fundamental voltage. This is the thing. And this fifth harmonics is given by some equation, which is a nonlinear equation, cos of theta 1 plus some cos theta 2. Is equal to 0 or something. Okay, so like this, it is like, this is the fifth. So this fifth harmonics is cos phi theta 1, cos phi theta 2, is 0. In the sense, this is a minimization problem. I want to remove my harmonics in my supply. Say for example, if this is my AC supply, this is my AC supply. In this, I have harmonics like this. I want to eliminate this. So this harmonics voltage is this fifth harmonic voltage, which will be five cycles in one cycle. In this five cycle, there is one, like, sorry, in this one cycle, there is five cycles there. That is the fifth harmonics or seventh harmonics. It's something like this. So because of this, what will happen? My overall voltage will be some dips like this. This is my resultant voltage. This I have to avoid because it may disturb, like it may degrade my instrument's quality or the different load quality. Okay, so I have to eliminate all these harmonics. So what I want is this fifth harmonic voltage should be zero. That is what I have written here. Similarly, the seventh harmonic should be. So I will have different equations. So in order to solve this fitness function, I require this theta. Alpha 1, this theta 1, theta 2, these are my different values which I require so that I will go and put it inside this and I can solve this. Okay, so this theta 1, theta 2, all these values are, this will be given as my population. Population is nothing but the solution which I should get. Okay, the solution which I should get, that is the population. Okay. For example, say traveling salesman problem, if you take your distance, your cost function will be the minimum distance. With minimum distance, it has to travel to all the locations. Okay, so you have different locations, that is XY plot. If you're two-dimensional plot, if you do XY positions, different positions you have. And your cost function will be your distance. There you will find the Euclidean distance. Is it? Say for example, there are some cities, say some two cities or three cities I am taking like this. When you want to find the distance, Euclidean distance, the cos function, how will you write? Your cos function will be summation of all the n cities. How many cities are there? It will be the square root of x minus x1, the whole squared, this is said to be the Euclidean distance, plus y minus. So I was just thinking, because many are from computer science, so I was thinking what example to give. This traveling salesman is a better one, I think. So this one. Okay. So this is the your cost function. That is the Euclidean distance you are just calculating. So in this case, your position, this x and y positions will be your different population. Can you get it? Your population, you will be defining the x and y position with different, you will say, there are 30 cities. There are 30 cities. So if there are 30 cities, if you want to solve this problem by calculus technique or something, it is 30 factorial by 2. 1.3 into 10 to the power, some 32 different possibilities you have to solve. 10 to the power 32, you just think 10 and 32 circles. So how long it will take? So there is an option that you can do it. This optimization, what it does, it solves and it goes and finds a point and it will give you the answer. In such places, where you want to, we have lot of solution and you want to find one peak solution, then you go for such algorithms. So here in this case, in this 1.3 in 10 to the power this much solution, you take some 30 solution, okay, and you solve them, put those positions into it, solve this fitness function, you get some answers, then you will rearrange them and then evaluate them, then you take do all these process and you will find who is best in that and keep them and again take another set of population. Then you will be able to identify that in which location it is there. This is a random search. You're searching here, then you're taking a population from here, you're searching, you're taking a population from here and searching. Then you'll come to a conclusion that, okay, my solution is somewhere at this corner. Okay, one corner. Then what I first, I will explore. The crossover process will do this exploration. Mutation, what it does, it will exploit. Now I identified that my solution is in this corner. Once I've explored, then I'll exploit that position and then find the peak. Okay, so first putting different things so that what is population, because many times we have a conclusion is in population what do we choose. Okay, population is nothing but your solutions. You just take your solution according to your problem, take your solution. It may be a bit string. Okay, mainly when we solve with computer, mostly binary numbers, because computer will understand in zeros and ones. Or you can have octal, hexadecimal, any type of numbers. It may be any real numbers. In case of this traveling salesman, it is an integer, the position of X and Y. So it may be some permutation of elements, list of rules, be also there. So anything. So population is nothing but, just think, in our body, if you say it is a chromosome with all those DNAs, which is having all the features of our eyes, skin, also you will get a human being, is it? So that is the population. So how will you choose this population? How much population should we choose? It depends on the problem. If you choose a very big population, good. But what will be the problem? Time consumption. It will take a lot. If I take a small population, sometimes the whole search space will not be utilized. You will get like a local peak mein jaake aap phas jayenge. So you have to optimally choose how much should be your population. And this is a very big question, ma'am, how to choose the population. So usually, again, say, we have to come to a conclusion. Sometimes, say, many times, trial and error also we do it. But actually, you can't say. What you can do is, you can say, if you have very small population also, I've avoided, I've taken not taken big population, you have taken some medium one and you have solved it. And if you see that, okay, it is terminating, then you can reduce the population size and see whether it is achieved. Say 10 you have reduced, again you can get it, then again reduce it. Because how much small population, your problem will run faster. Okay, so but say that small population is not giving, then you can go to the thing. Okay, so there is no exact formulas to tell you that this is the population. And many a times, as ma'am said, when we go for a particular type of problem, say power system for optimal location, we go and search papers, mostly 30 or 40 will be the population size, we do it. And again, then after doing that, we cut down and then choose the exact population. Okay, so this is how we choose the population. So population size, the population size depicts the number of chromosomes in one generation. Generation is nothing but the number of iteration. You choose one population and you make them undergo the crossover, mutation, evaluation, everything. So that is one generation. After that, you select a set and you send them to the next generation. So the number of iteration, total number of iteration, what you have chosen is nothing but your generation. So this I have already explained, population size. Next is selection. You have chosen a population. Now you have to select some people from them. So there are different techniques to select it. The most common technique used is the roulette wheel selection. Okay, that I'll be explaining in detail. Otherwise, you have tournament selection. You have two groups, conduct a tournament among them and choose which is the best. Rank selection, evaluate everyone, put a rank, then do it. Boltzmann selection is based on temperature, like thermal equilibrium. Okay, so again, probability of energy function you find there, whether based on the energy, based on, say, if you want more clearly to explain, probability of a thermal equilibrium system is, the probability of energy is given by this equation, that is equal to exponential of minus e plus, sorry, this is divided, minus e divided by kt. Okay, so this is the equation. So in this case, k is the Boltzmann constant, T is the temperature at equilibrium, like the temperature at the of the system, and E is the energy. So in this case, what we say is, like, if the temperature is high, the probability of the energy function is uniform. For low energy, high energy, anything, the probability is uniform. But when the temperature is low, the probability of getting a higher energy level is very less. Okay, so based on this equation also, you can select the group. Okay, so there are different techniques. Steady state selection is, you evaluate everyone, the one who is giving best solution, you automatically take it to the next group. So I say you can also come out with your own selection technique. So Boltzmann says, this is roulette wheel selection. I will just explain. In roulette wheel selection, what we do, I already told you about the fitness function. Okay, you have a fitness function, and in that fitness function, what you will do, each and every individual you have evaluated, say 5 people were there, I evaluated them individually. So that individual person's fitness function divided by sum of all the 5 will give you the probabilistic function. Okay, so the probability of the first person is 31%. Okay, can you see this clearly? And the probability of the second person is 5. Okay, the probability of the third person getting selected is 38%. So this is a roulette wheel I have made. Now what I do, I'll rotate this roulette wheel. So what is the probability of this pin getting selected? It is more, is it? It is around 38%. So you can see that as generation passes on, all these person, like the number 2, 4 and 5 will automatically get eliminated. Okay, so this is the roulette wheel selection. Can you get it? So once we do a small problem, you'll understand it. Okay, then you undergo the process called reproduction. After selecting the population, they undergo this reproduction. Then the modification. So modification, you have two. One is crossover and one is mutation. So why do we do crossover? Crossover is nothing but exploration. It will explore the whole space, and mutation will exploit it. So that is about crossover and mutation. So what is crossover? Say you have two humans, like male and a female, and you cross them. So here, and just imagine that they are carriers of some disease. Let us imagine that they are the carriers of sugar. Both parents are having sugar. Okay, so now what happens? Their offspring, their children, there is a chance, 1/1/4 chance that there will be an unaffected child. The child will not have that disease. 1/4 chance that the child may be fully affected. Okay, or there is 1/2 chance, half of the chance that they are also carriers. So there are 1/2 chance that they are carriers here. Okay, this is crossover, how it goes on. Here you can see children, they are all looking different, but they are all siblings from same parents. So that is crossover. When two different, say here you have a black man and a white woman, after crossing you can see the children. There may be a white child, there may be a black child or a brown child. It, after crossing, what happens is some of the features are carried to their child, carries some of the features of their parents. Okay, so this is crossover in real human. I am telling, we will go into a problem and see how it happens in human. So here also, not only the color or these things, many features, many characteristics also they carry. So here you can see mom and child, how similar they look, mom and the child. Here grandfather and grandson, their features almost they are similar. Similarly here, father and son, they are both guitarists. So it is all the characteristics or some fear, some special what to say, talents, they are also being carried on by this crossover. So in crossover, we are just taking two parents. Okay, see here we are just representing that chromosome in the form of binary numbers. In my problem which I showed you first, it was the angle I said. Okay, so that angle may be 30 degrees 40 degrees. So that 30 degrees, if you want, in the form of binary, you can write it, or you can write it as integers also. You can solve your problem. So here, this is your chromosome. Okay, so this is a string of chromosome. This is your parent, one parent, and this is male and this is female. Now one point crossover, at one particular point I am crossing it. So what happens, the first chromosome for the first child I am taking as such from the mother, and the second from their father. So this is the new child. Similarly, in the second case, I am taking from the father and the other half from the mother. So here, if you see, for this second child, the feature of mother is more than the father. So she or he will carry more feature of that mother. Okay, so this is how. So in this same case, you can do two-point crossover. You can cross it at two different points. Or three point, multiple point. It depends on the algorithm, how you write it. How do you want to cross it? There is no such rules. That's why we say this is an algorithm. If you can come out with a different technique and it is giving a better solution, then that is best. Okay, so this is two point where mother's characteristics we have taken the outer two and father's inner. Similarly for the other child. So this is the two point crossover. You can have arithmetic crossover. Because these are all addition, subtraction, multiplication. So here you can have AND logic. This is one of your parent, mother, father, and you are doing ANDing them. Say 1 and 1, 1 you get, 1, 0, you get 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. So you can AND them or XOR, anything you can apply. So these are the different ways by which you do crossover. So first we selected using different techniques like roulette wheel, selection or crossover, like sorry, tournament or rank or any technique you use, Boltzmann constant, all these things you can use. Select a population. Then that population may be a string. It may be binary, digital, depending on your problem. And then you can do crossover. Again, 1 point crossover, 2 point crossover, arithmetic crossover, many. There are endless crossover. If you go into literature and see, many people have come out with different crossover techniques. So there is no hard rule that this is what you have to use. This again, you can go with different techniques, because that is nature. Okay, in every our human body also, it may be a different type of crossover. For one person, it may be a 1 point, multiple point, different ways. What is mutation? In the whole string, if one particular string, if you're not doing crossover anything, you are wantingly changing it. Physically, you're going and changing that value. The value was 32. You have made it 30. Or the value was 1. I've made it 0. So that is mutation. So always in your problem, if there is a lucky mutation, you will get a better solution. Okay, so mutation is just like a luck. If you don't do more mutation also, then your whole thing will get changed. So by default, like you can have a thing that you can have do 10% mutation. In any problem, 10%. If there are 10 digits, one digit you can change, not more than that. That is said to be the thing. And in mutation, say, when there is a positive mutation, you get persons like Einstein or Aishwarya Rai, like more beautiful or more IQ person you can get. Because Einstein's father and mother, they were not high IQ people, but the son is high IQ, that is because of mutation. If it is a wrong mutation, what solution you want to get, that will not be the thing. You have to discard it. So you can see here persons with more number of fingers and a person with a different head. There is Pa, you have seen a film Pa, where they have a different like Brown syndrome or a different syndrome. Okay, so these are the ill effects of this mutation. So what is mutation? You have a string like this. In that, this was the string of a parent. You suddenly change one of the thing. Okay, you just change one particular digit. So this is mutation. Say you had 69.4, you did a mutation. So if it's a positive mutation, then it is, you will get a better solution. So here there is a, you can see here we have done mutation. We have taken a string here, and I think around 32 digits are there together, both. So 32 are there. I am doing mutation in three places. Okay, 10%, that is one, this one, and this one. I am just changing it. So this one I have changed to zero. This zero I have changed to one, and this zero I have changed to one. So this is my mutated offspring, mutated child. This is the crossover child, and this is the mutated child. The crossover, and that is why I have told you many times, crossover, what it does is it does big jumps. It will not take small steps. It does big jumps, and it will explore that area. Mutation will take small steps. So if you do, if you find ki my mutation is that which does, it exploits it. Why don't I do mutation? The problem is it takes small step, and it will take a lot of time. So mutation should be done after doing crossover. For that particular area, you do mutate. That is, you, if you are sure that the solution is there, then you mutate it in small steps, and you will go and find it. Crossover and mutation, that is, only crossover can combine information from two parents. Only mutation can introduce new information or alleles. Alleles are those proteins which has better solution. So crossover does not change the allele frequency of the population. To hit the optimum, you need a lucky mutation. If you want to find the thing, you have to go for a lucky mutation. So after these things, after doing this, you evaluate the child. How will you evaluate? Whatever solution you get, you put it into your fitness function and evaluate it. So here, evaluation, if the offspring is able to adapt to the situation, then you will take. Otherwise, you will discard them. So here you can see the picture of sparrows. In like many centuries before, the sparrows had very big beak, and they had very big beaks, and they had very big feathers. But as generation went on, they didn't get food, so automatically the beak size also reduced, because the like big food, more food, you require more thing. So now it changed, and now you can see the sparrows with very small beaks and small feathers. So it has adapted. So if such a solution we get, we take them to the next generation. Otherwise, you have to discard them. So you would have heard about the story of eagles. So eagles, the life of eagle is only 30 years. Okay. But it can live till 70 if it undergoes a process. After 30 years, what happens to the eagle is their beak will bend, or it will grow and it will bend like this. So it will not be able to eat more food, and its feathers also will grow very big. So it will not be able to eat food, and it will starve and it will die. So at that time, what this bird does is it flies up in the mountains, goes, sits there, and it will try to break its beak. It sheds all its feathers, and it is a very painful time. Many of the times the eagles will die. It takes some 2 or 3 months for it to recover. After that, what happens when its beak is broken? Then new beaks will come. New feathers will come. Once it retrieves that, then again it can live for 40 years. So the total 70 years life it gets if it is fit. If it is not fit, it will die. Same process takes place in our problem also. You have given a solution. If it is able to adapt, it will go to the next generation. Otherwise, it will die. All these things are taken from nature itself. So if the population is not good, discard it. One of the best examples is dinosaurs. You would have seen these dinosaurs. It fully got extinct because it couldn't adapt to the situation. So termination criteria, as also I already told you, how will you terminate? Reaching a maximum number of generation, you will terminate. Successive iteration does not provide proper result, that you will terminate. And optimal fitness value of the population is reached, again, you will terminate. So let us take a very simple problem. Okay, and first we will solve it step by step. Then we'll take maximization problem. We'll take a minimization problem and solve it with MATLAB. Then we'll step by step go into different applications. So considering a problem of maximization, f of x is equal to x squared. I've taken a very simple problem, because step by step, if I want to show, if it is a big problem, it will be difficult. So we have taken a very simple problem. Here f of x is x squared. Okay, and my x value is permitted between 0 and 31. If I put the 0 and 31, it should give me my maximum value. F of x maximum I have to get. So what I'm doing is, since I'm solving it in computer, I let me just put it as a string. So this 0, the initial value 0, 0, 0, I have kept. And for this 31, I have kept it as 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Okay, code x into the finite length string. I put it as a string. So these are my solutions, is it? This is my solution also, like the x value is given and this is my solution. So I've just taken my solution and select the initial population. So here from 0, 0, 0, 0, you have 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1. You have number of combinations. From this combination, I have to select a population. So first, randomly, because I'll generate a random number there when I'm doing the problem. So I'm just randomly selecting four populations. Okay, randomly. I'm selecting here four. You can take a higher number, but I'm selecting four just to solve, show you the calculation. Okay, simple four. And again, four I have taken, one parent, like one male and one female is required to do all the process. So here I've taken four. And calculate the fitness value. This is selection using roulette wheel. Okay, so I'll be finding the fitness function. I'll be summing everything and I'll be finding the probability. So this is what I have to do. So I've first, in the selection process, I've selected four population size. So the numbers which I've selected from 0 to 31 is 12, 25, 5, and 19. Don't think that I have selected wantingly. This is randomly I've generated. You can use rand, R-A-N-D, rand in MATLAB and generate randomly. After that, you have to put it in your fitness function. Okay, your fitness function, as I already told, this traveling salesman problem or the THG minimization, the equation, how will you write? It depends on your problem. Your problem may be different, difficult, different. You have to just see which is the function I want to minimize. It may be a cost of a building, the material, the steel, rod, all these things. So that will be your cost function. So anything, depending on your problem, choose it. So in this case, f of x is x squared is your cost function. So 12 squared is nothing but 144. So I am just putting this value inside my fitness function. So 144, 625, 25, 5 squared is 25, 19 squared is 361. I did the sum of all these numbers. Sum of all these is this. The average of all these things is 288.75. The maximum value of this is 625. I've just calculated it. Next, I'm finding for selection, I have to find the probability. So this is roulette wheel selection. Any other technique, you will have that formula here. Okay. So here the probability is f of x, that is 144 divided by sum of all these functions. Sum is 1155. So 144 divided by 1155 is your 0.1247. 0.54, these are the different values. I think you understood how we got it. Again, percentage, because I want to see what is the wheel. So here, 12.47, 54 and 2.16 and 31.26. So from this itself, you can understand that 54, this one is more close to the solution. Is it? Because it is 625. Yeah, simple problem, so you can identify. If it is a very big problem, as I told, 1.3 into 10 to the power 36, you can't go and find it. In that case, you have to run the program. So here, you can just, when you see the roulette wheel, 50%, 54% in the sense, you will get one slot like this. And like another is 31. So let me keep it something like this. This is 131. This is my 54 and 12. So this is my 12. And this is my 2. 2 should be very small. So anyway, so in this, when I rotate it, my probability of this area getting selected is more. So for understanding purpose, again, you find the expected count so that it will give you in the form of zeros and ones so that I can say if it is zero less than one, eliminate it, and greater than one or one, you take it. So in order to bring it in that form, or from here also, you can, if you know, like from here, if it is the highest probability, if you can take and do it, you can do it. But mostly we do it in this form so that you will get a clear idea that which are the numbers to take. So for that, expected count is nothing but, the expected count is f of x That is f of x is this value, 144, divided by average. Average is this one. So 144 divided by 288, that is 0.4. This 2.1 like this you will get. And now 0.49, I can round it off 1. 2, I can round it as 2. This 0 and 1. So from this, which one will get eliminated? This 0. So you are sure that I will not select the 0. All the other 3, I can select. So when you do the problem, also selection, you give a factor, 0.9. In the sense, if there are 30, around 27, you can select and discard the other. So usually we give a weighting factor also when we solve the problem, that how much should we discard? I want to discard 5%, I want to discard 10%, that in the form of a weighting factor, you will be giving it. So this is the selection process. Now what I will do is I will discard this number, okay? And I will repeat this same number here. Because this selected value, I have to do crossover and mutation. If I eliminate that string, what will happen is then I can't do the crossover and mutation. So this is only one iteration is going on. I have not gone to the next generation. So what I'm doing, I am discarding this and repeating the best one again. So this 2 has the best here. So I'll repeat this number here. So what I did in this crossover process, what I did is I took the first two as such, the third one I discarded and I repeated the same thing here. You can see these two numbers are same. And fourth one as such. Now I have to do crossover. There are many crossovers. So I have two sets of parents here. I can do single point crossover, multiple crossover, arithmetic crossover, anything. So here what I'm doing is, here in this fourth, at the fourth point I'm doing a crossover. For the other parent I'm doing at the third. If you want, same place also you can do. That is your wish at what type you want to do. So here what I'm doing, fourth point in the sense, from the mother I'm bringing the data here, and this one I'm crossing it here. In this case, the 0, 1, I'll be bringing it down, and this 1, 1, I'll be taking up. So in the program, when you write it, this is a string, then you will be as an array there, till fourth you will be removing it, and from that, last two digit of two parents, you will be swapping it. So that is what you have done here. So here the 1 has gone up and the 0 has come down here. So this is offspring after crossover. Now you will be writing the value. This is nothing but 13, 24, 27 and 17. Now fitness value, that evaluate and see. So you will get it as 169. 5, how did you evaluate it? F of x is equal to x squared. So put this x value here, you will get this value. Okay. So now this process is not over. Next, we have to do mutation. Okay. So next, now what we do, this offsprings. This is a new offspring now. We will eliminate this also. We have done crossover and we have got this. So this we will take for mutation. So now I have taken that parent here, offspring after crossover, that parent I have taken, and mutation. So here, there are 10 variables. So only 10%, that is one variable I can change. So you know that there is a general thing also. This is a, what problem is this? Maximization problem. So you can see that whenever you want to maximize something, the last digit from 0, if you do 1, that will take you to the better solution. So whenever you do mutation also, depending on your problem, you should know which place should I mutate. You can go and mutate at any place. But if you give the correct location, then the solution will, better solution, faster it will come. Okay. You can even mutate here. This 1 you can make 0. So, but what will happen? Again, the solution is going down. It will not go up. Okay. So the mutation. So in this case, I have mutated at this location. If you mutate this, this will be a better one. But I am mutating at this. So this is a mutation chromosome. What I am doing at 1, this is the place I want to mutate. Others 0. 0, 0, 0, here also I don't want to do anything, and this variable I want to mutate. Now you do some arithmetic operation and get that this 0 will become 1 here. Okay, so this 0 will become 1 here, this will become 1 here, and this will become 1. So the same thing, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, I brought it here. Similarly, I've brought all these variables. Now, what is this? This is nothing but my 29. So this is my 24, this is 27, and this is 20. So if I find the fitness value, this is only one generation, one iteration. You can see that when after selecting the population, how fast it brought in one iteration also, almost it brought to my solution. So this is 841. Okay, so now one iteration is over. Now the same thing, this parent will go to the next iteration, it will go on, and finally it will give me the solution. So this is how the step by step, the internal process is going on. Okay, so now let us do a small problem in MATLAB. I'll show you how to write a fitness function and all these things. So here, minimize the following fitness function including two variables. So your last one is a maximization, this is a minimization problem. So in this minimization problem, this is the function given, f of x is equal to 100 x1 squared minus x2 the whole squared plus 1 minus x1 the whole squared. So this function is said to be my cost function, otherwise objective function, or the fitness function. Different books gives different title for this. Okay, they are some say it as fitness function, some say as cost function, some as objective, but they are all the same. This is our objective function, and there are some constraints here. Okay, the constraint is x1 x2 plus x1 minus x2 plus 15 should be less than or equal to 0. So the constraints may be equal constraints or non-equal constraints. There are two types of constraints. If you put this is equal to 0, it is equal constraint. Otherwise, it is said to be non-equal constraints. So my x1 and x2 value should satisfy this condition. That is what they have given. Second constraint is 10 minus x1, x2 is less than or equal to 0. And there are some bounds also. My x1 should be greater than 0 and less than 1. And my second bound is x2 should be greater than 0 and less than 13. So there are two bounds also given. There are constraints, there are bounds, and this. So how to solve this? First, we will just open a MATLAB script file. So all of you know MATLAB script file opening, you know it. So open a script file and you have to write the fitness function. So function y is equal to my fitness. You can give any function name here. I'm writing it as my fitness of x. Okay, so here x has two variables, x1 and x2. So I'm just defining it as my fitness of x. So y is equal to that fitness function which I showed you, 100 into, depending on the software, say MATLAB for multiplication, you put it like this. For depending on different, whichever software you're using, you can do it. X of 1 square minus x2 the whole square plus 1 minus x of 1 the whole square and end. So this is my fitness function. So your problem, cost function, efficiency, or accuracy, error minimization, whichever thing, that will be coming here, your fitness function. If you want to just solve it and see, if you put my fitness and give two values here, if you give my fitness and send the two x1 and x2 value, it will simply solve and show, but this is not required now. Next is the constraints. There were two constraints. Okay, so same. So So this is the function given to me. This is a function given. It's a cost function. It may be a THD minimization. It may be an error minimization function or any function. Okay. Your Euclidean distance in case of traveling salesman problem. This problem, you have to write it as a function. Because what generally we do at the last is, there is a function called GA in MATLAB. So this GA requires different functions. One, it requires a fitness function. Okay, it requires otherwise objective function, you say. That function is nothing but this function. Then it requires how many variables are there. So here, how many variables are there? Two variables. So that you will be giving. Then you will be giving the different constraints. Here you will be saying the equal constraints. Then you will be giving the non-equal constraints. At last, you will be giving some options. Okay, those options are crossover, which type of crossover. That also, you can give it as different functions. Okay, so at least, so these are the differences. So now what we have to do, we have to write program for this fitness function. We have to write program for this constraints. We have to write program for this options. And then we will put it here and run the whole program. Okay. So here, this function, where this x1 value and x2 value, they have given some constraints. Our x1 and x2 should satisfy these two constraints. Okay. And the other thing is, this x1 should be greater than 0 and less than 1. This is my constraint in my case. Say in the THD problem, total harmonic distortion case, which I was telling, according to IEEE, the total harmonic distortion should be less than 5%. So that is my constraint there. It should be less than 5%. And if you take a like sine wave here, say I am taking some step waves like this. It depends on your problem, which type of problem you are choosing, it depends. So here, if it's a sine wave, you all know that what is the full angle? 360. So this is 180. Half is 180. So which theta 1, theta 2, what I'm saying is this is theta 1. This is your theta 1. And this is my theta 2. And say this is my theta 5. Let me keep it as a, like in between also terms are there. So can I write the constraint for this? What should be my theta 1? How should be my, what will be my constraint for theta 1? It should be greater than 0, but less than theta 2. Is it? What will be my theta 2 constraint? Greater than theta 1, but less than theta 3. What will be my last constraint, theta 5? It should be greater than theta 4, but less than? Not 180. 90 degrees, is it? Because this is half symmetry I'm taking. So 90 degrees. Similarly, each and every problem will have some constraints. So here they have given some constraint. For this problem, our constraint is my x1 and x2 should be like this. They have given. So you have to choose your problem and you have to find your constraint. Okay. Similarly, they have given the x1 bounds also. Like say if there is a circle. Okay, so my x value, my diameter is between 0 and 1. They have given it. Or my x2 is 0 and 13. It is already given. So these are the, this is the problem given to me. First, what I have to do, I have to write program for this fitness function, my objective function. So that was written here. So this is the general form. How will you write a function in MATLAB? Function y is the output. Function y is equal to the function name you have to give, my fitness x. Any function name you can give. It may be my name also. Shimi of x can also be written. Okay, no problem. And this is the function which I showed you there. 100 into x1 squared minus x2, the whole squared plus this. And end. Got it? Or you had some doubt? Okay. Next is my constraint. My constraint, there are two constraints I said. In this case, I have not taken any equal constraints. So I am just putting it blank. I have non-equal constraints. So that I have put it here. These are my non-equal constraints. So I had two constraints. Do you remember it? This is one constraint, semicolon, and the second constraint I have given. This is my x minus x1 plus x2 is constraint was less than or equal to 10. Okay. So that constraint I have written here. And this is the other constraint. And we have to just write C equal. That is, I just want the output of non-equal constraint, equal constraint, and my constraint function. This is my constraint function. Okay. One second. I can just show you the constraint. These were the two constraints. Okay. 10 minus x1, x2 less than or equal to 0. Okay. So this was my constraint, which I... So this is x1, x2, it was, or bada nahi hoga. Dikh nahi rahe. So here it is, yaha semicolon, first constraint here, and this is non-equal constraint. When it is less than or equal to, what you can do is from the right-hand side, bring everything this side. Non-equal constraints can be written like this. This is the first constraint, put a semicolon. If there are 10 constraint, again put a semicolon, write the next, then again next constraint like this. Within square brackets. Within square brackets you have to write.
Less than equal to 0.
Non-equal constraints. So what you have to do is, one second.
X1, x2 plus x1 minus x2 plus 1.
If there is some term this side, you will bring it. This is non-equal constraint, that is less than or equal to 0. So for non-equal terms, only this we will take. Put it in the semicolon. After semicolon, again, this one. That is greater than or equal to, you're saying. This is less than or equal to, less than or equal to 1. Bring it this side. Bring it. It should be with compared to 0. Equality is equal to 0. If so, there are some terms this side, bring it towards your left side. Equation, in the equation, on the right hand side, it should be 0. Bring all the parameters to this side. Like if it is 10 here, bring it as minus 10, and the whole term, semicolon, how many constraints are there, you will be writing it. Equal to constraint, you will put it inside the same way, but you will put it inside this block. So here for equal to, and this here, non-equal constraints, you get it. Okay, is it clear? You have to bring the whole side here. Every time take it as greater than or equal to. Okay. Not equal to. No, it is less than or equal to 0. Which are the parameters here? Try to bring it this side. And always see that it is less than or equal to. In the form that. Okay.
Empty bracket.
There is nothing. We didn't give any equality constraints. So it is an empty bracket here. Okay, so it is an empty bracket there. Okay, so next is our main program. So this is the main program. I am writing my objective function is equal to @myFitness. So I think you remember this myFitness function which we wrote first. @myFitness automatically it will call that. Okay, you have to open that function and keep. Next is how many number of variables were there? Unknown variables, 2. So I am defining it. Lower bounds, you have to give the lower bounds and upper bounds here. So the lower bounds is 0 and 0. X1 also 0, Y1 also, sorry, X1 and X2, both the cases lower bounds were 0. What was the upper bound? 1 and 13. Can you get it? X1 should be between 0 and 1. X2 should be between 1 and 13. So your lower bounds are 0 and 1, your upper bounds are, sorry, 0 and 0, and your upper bounds are 1 and 13. Okay, is it clear? So I think you can see the screen here. So first we wrote the objective function. I showed you a function, that this is the objective function. The number of variables I have given, because in MATLAB that is a syntax. This is how we have to give. The lower bounds. Okay, because our x1 was between 0 and 1 and our x2 was 0 and 13. So 0, both the cases it is 0 and the upper bound was 1 and 13. So that I have written. The constraint function @ my constraint. So the equality and inequality constraints, that function also I wrote and showed you. So that is this function. Now, in order to solve this and get the answer, there is a function in MATLAB called GA. So this GA function we will be using. GA of the objective function. So this is the objective function. So you can have any name. You can have A is equal to this also. There is nothing that you have to keep it as objective. Whichever name you give it here, write it here. Or you can even directly give this @ my fitness also here. There is no problem in that. Number of variables. There are 2 variables. So here also, again, you can write 2 directly. But to make it a little more clear, I have written as number of variables. Here, some things which I have left, that is nothing but the equal and non-equal constraints. Okay. So here, constraint function, that is unequal constraint function is coming here. But for equal constraint functions, you will be putting here. And which other things which you don't require also, you can, which you are not using, you put the square bracket, like null matrix like that. Okay. I'll show you the syntax also in GA. What are the different possibilities? Next, the lower bound and the upper bound. So this is what is the program. Now let me run it in MATLAB and show you. So whichever folder you have, this is the current folder you have to choose in order to run the program. So I have some programs here. Okay, so I have already written. So main is a program which I opened you and showed. Okay, so this is the main program. I think you remember it. Objective function, this one. Okay, so let me choose the... So what are the other programs which we have to open? One is my constraint. So I'm just opening the my constraint. So my main program is here. This is my main program, objective function at the rate my fitness. I think all of you know to open a script file, is it? Go to open and new, and there script files are there. So open a script file and you have to just type this. Okay, you have to just type this. Okay, so main function, constraint, and one more we have to open, objective function. So my fitness. So you can see the my fitness function. Okay, so this is my fitness which I showed you. 100 into x1, this same thing. Open a script file and write this in MATLAB. Okay, similarly, my constraint, that is also opened and that is written here. And the main program, that is also written here. So now this main program you have to run in MATLAB. In the editor, you have this icon, just click on this. So this program will run. So you can see here, it has given me the values. X1 is this, X2 is this. So X1 is between 0 and 1, X2 is between 1 and 13. And it has evaluated the value and it has given me the value. Okay. Same thing, if you feel coding is difficult, I can't. This is for the people who want to write their own crossover mutation. I'll show you one more problem where that crossover mutation can also be written by you. Okay, so this is a simple thing for a starting thing. Do this, you'll get confident. So here, this one, same thing, the GA toolbox also you can do it. So if you are difficult, if you find difficulty in write, just write GA tool. Those who are not from computer science, or if you're from civil, electrical, and all, they find it difficult. So you can directly, it'll give you the same answer. I'll just solve and show you. It'll give you the same answer. So GA tool. So this is the GA tool, toolbox. The overall toolbox looks like this. Okay. So here, in order to learn also, if you go GA tool, you put and just go the all the problems, constraints, population, they have given a very good literature there. Yeah, these problems also I took it from the literature only for learning purpose. Okay, so it is very good. They have given different conditions and how to write, what are the different crossover functions, everything is given. If you go and now with a small idea, if you go and do, you can do it. So first of all, GA algorithm, there are different search algorithms available. GA I have chosen. Our fitness function, so I have to write my fitness function. So what was my fitness function? Here, whenever you want to call it at the rate, in MATLAB, at the rate, my fitness. So this was a problem. Last case also I wrote. So that fitness function is here. And whichever programs which you have written, it should be on the current folder. You know what is current folder? See, this one here, this is the current folder. So where your program is, that should be your current folder. Otherwise, you will get an error. You will not understand why you are not getting. Always see that with whenever your fitness function and constraint function should be in your current folder. So write at the rate my fitness. Number of variables is 2. And the lower bounds, it was 0 and 0. Is it? And upper bound was 1 and 13. Square brackets you can write. Non-linear constraint function we gave, linear for equalities and all, we have not taken in this problem. non-linear constraint function is this, at the, again, this we are calling a program function. So at the rate, you have to write at the rate my constraints. Okay, so this is how you will be writing it and start the problem. So here, in this case, you can see it has given me that same value. 1.3578 was the thing, same value it has given, and it will give you the x value and y value also here. See the same value, 0.8122, same thing you get it here. So using GA toolbox also, the same answer will come. Okay, GA toolbox also you can do it. And here in GA toolbox, they have given all the options here, population, fitness function, selection. So those who are like, you have different selection functions, roulette wheel you want, tournament you want, it will automatically put and it will do it. If you want to write the code, say this roulette wheel also, you want to do some modification, the code, then you have to go and write your own program. Otherwise, if you can go and choose reproduction, what are the different functions available, the constraints and everything is given here. You can just try, many problems are given in the examples. For examples, what you have to do is, two ways you can go. If you go to this f of x function here in MATLAB, just GA, say this again, I have take this, okay, taken. Like I told you, if you want to give some options, so GA optim is a command which you give, optim set. So if you click, go to this f of x, write GA optim set. Here the syntax are given. So go to more help. So if you go to more help, here they have given the thing GA optim set parameter 1, value 1, parameter 2, value 2. That is nothing but say crossover. So you'll give at the rate that function, which program you have written, crossover program. And you will give the values, like you can give 0.8, like a weighting function also you can give. Okay, I want 0.8 of this to be taken. So all these things, they have explained clearly. And there are different functions also given here. You can just go through. So it's a very big list. Many functions, inbuilt functions are available. So for you can see here, for creation function, you have some GA creation uniform. Crossover also you can see here. Crossover function, crossover heterotic, crossover scatter, crossover intermit, crossover single point. So many functions. At the rate, they have already given these programs are already written. If you don't want this, that function, you write it and you can have your own functions. So they have given all these things, for many options are available. And one simple program I will show. We are getting a little late, but one simple program. So this is a program what I was telling about the THD. It was in my PhD program when I was writing. That program is this. So here many options were tried. So it is thing like, even with the same program, I did PS also. Only thing is, at the place of GA, you can see here, I removed this GA. I remove GA and I put PSO and give the corresponding fitness functions are also same, constraints are same, only slight different. Even PSO can be run. Okay, so for PSO, what you have to do is, you have to go to the PSO toolboxes in MATLAB File Exchange. It is not in MATLAB. You have to go to Google and search for MATLAB File Exchange. Number of, for any algorithm, like you have PSO, you have Firefly. If you go to MATLAB File Exchange and search for it, you can download those toolbox as such. And when you want to run the toolbox, keep it in your current folder. Okay, so here if you see this program, when if I run, it'll ask me to keep it in the current folder. This is the fitness function. You can, like for GA, I'll tell you, because we were doing GA. So here Z value and the fitness value I wanted. Okay, so here, as I told you, my Z values are my different angles, theta 1, theta 2. What are the best angles at which I get minimum THD? My THD should be less than 5%, I told you. So here, GA, I am this. This is nothing but my fitness function. So what I did is already I have written different fitness function because I am not sure which fitness function will be giving me best. So I have taken some fitness function which are already there in literature. I have written my own fitness function with slight variations. And those things are fitness 1, fitness 2, fitness 3. I have kept different fitness. At one time, I will be running 1. So now I have kept 3 in the sense I am running my third fitness function. Okay. And each fitness function, I will save all those values so that with different fitness function also, I can compare my graphs and all those things. So this is for the fitness function. The number of variables are, I have 5 firing angles. Theta 1, theta 2, theta 3, theta 4, theta 5, I said, na? So these are the 5 firing angles. These are my constraints. It is a 5x5 matrix. Mine was a 5x5 matrix. So these are the equal and non-equal constraints. Those things which I'm not using, I have removed it. And at last, in syntax, you have something called options. This option is for giving your crossover, mutation. But in the simple problem which I showed, if you don't give also, MATLAB will take its default. It has some default functions it will take. Okay, so here, this options was defined here. So you can see here, options, GA optim set. The optimal set I am just giving. So here I am defining whichever I want. In that last case also, I didn't give any generation population. It has taken its own. So here I can give my generation. The value is 100. My creation function, I have just called the creation function at the rate. This is a MATLAB function which is already there. Or if you have written your own program, now you know crossover. You take a string, which point you want to crossover. If you write a small program, you just save it. And at the rate, you can call it here. Then the population range. You can give what is the range of your population, mutation, which type of mutation function you want to give, crossover fraction, that is 70% of the population I am taking. So that weight factor also I can give, crossover function, population size. So this is the population size of 30 I have given, and plotting function, best values it has to plot. So this is a program. Actually, if I want to set this, it has to come to my path. So let me just. So this here, this is my program, main program. This was my fitness function. Okay, so fitness function. The fitness function, if you see, I already told you I want to minimize the THD, total harmonic distortion. And the total harmonic distortion depends, like was square root of the fifth harmonic, seventh harmonic. So this is what I've written. This is the fifth harmonic, my seventh harmonic with how many harmonics? I can go till many number. And this is my thing, square root of this squared plus this squared. So I've tried different fitness function also. Okay, so this is my fitness function. So according to your problem, you will be writing your fitness function and all the supporting. So I want to calculate my THD. So I have written the THD program. So what all programs you want, you can do it. And the main program, you will be running it. So add to path, because it is not in my path. So I'm just adding it. So it is solving. So around 50 iteration, it has solved and it has given me. So it will open my main MATLAB Simulink model also. And give me my, so this is the voltage you can see here, the output sine wave. So there are 5 steps, is it? So these steps, I have given the constraint that my theta 1 should be greater than 0, less than this. So it is giving me a perfect sine wave. And if I see the THD, it will be less than that 5%. I have not run this whole program because it will run for number of iteration. Only one iteration I have just shown you. So you can take your own thing and do. One more simple program I have, that is a traveling salesman program. So since this traveling salesman program is also there in the examples, so you can just go and see this. Here in this problem, they have not used any GA function. They have written each and everything, crossover, mutation. So you just go to the example and see this. Now you will understand it's still clear that how the step is going on. So this program also, it does the same. Different 30 cities are there. It finds the Euclidean mean and it will calculate it. So what it does, it calculates, it takes a particular population, say 10 to the power 32 combination, it takes only 30, it will solve, it will evaluate the fitness function, it will take that. From that, it will take to take the parents, it does crossover, after that it does mutation, all these things, what is it doing? The position X and Y. Okay, so that one only it is mutating crossover and it is trying different and it is seeing for which evaluation is giving the smallest distance, again putting into the thing, then it will discard the thing, then it will take the next set of population. You can write the program like this. So here, so these were different 30 cities and it tried different combination and it gave that 59 kilometers. With this, it will cover the whole distance. The best solution is this. Once again, one small slide I would like to show. So these were the 30 cities. The different combinations has gone. And finally, it has given a particular structure. So here in this case, if you see, now you will understand the graph what is coming. You can just see here. I think this itself is clear. This you can see here. These are the different generation. I gave 1,000 generation. See here, around 21 iteration or the generation, it has almost terminated. So you can give a termination criteria that if same thing is written, repeating, you can terminate here itself. So what are the different thing? What is the best value? What is the worst? Or what is the average? I'll tell you. For one iteration, this is one iteration. Let me say that the population size was 30. This 30 had run. The 30, each population I have taken, I have put it in the fitness function and it is giving me a distance. So here, the best fitness, that 30 people, one who gave the best distance was this maroon color. This around 900 and something. The one who gave worst was this 1,500 and something. And average of that whole 30 group was this blue. Then this was taken to the next iteration. So in the next iteration, if you see again, you can see this distance is reducing. The best has again reduced, best is around 750. And this is the worst and the average. And you can see as the iteration goes, almost at this point, it is terminating. After that, even go for 1,000 iteration, it is going to give you the same answer. So when that in that graph also, the one which was showing this is nothing but the average value was shown there. If you want the best and this worst also, you can plot it like this. It depends on how you are doing it. Okay, so now I think you understood that where to use GA. How will we go step by step? What is the internal thing? And this is like an ocean. Crossover also 100 functions are there. If you go for mutation, 100 function. So you have to choose which function you want. And depending on your problem, it may differ. Okay. So I yeah, if you have any questions, you can ask me.